You're here, thank you. Thank you so much. No, seriously, you are beloved. And then to be here in person, I was so happy to come to work today. So I'm serious, thank you for being here. This is a delight.
Can I have my shoes on this? Is that so rude?
But
no, it's a prop.
This is no, this is hanging out at Largo. It's Jesus, I'm surprised it's not covered in shit already.
Conan, when are you gonna put on your show outfit?
So cruel.
That's why Norman fell.
Yeah. Oh my God. My favorite thing is he'd say something. The camera's here, and he'd do a slam on Jack. Like, yeah, you're such a fairy, you could probably float there, and he would look there for I don't know 30 seconds. Loved it. What a great man.
It's almost what I just did to you. I mean, reference.
Almost. But you, it was a little different.
First of all, thank you for saving Largo.
Well, you know, someone had to. This theater was crumbling, falling apart. And as we know, this is one of the favorite theaters of all the cool comedy people in Los Angeles, and run by a genius. We call him Flanny, Flanagan. Yeah, Flanny's been keeping the theater going, and we've been working with this guy, and man, does he talk. Now, I'm highly suspicious of most of his stories because they always involve a very famous, iconic rock star. And it's always like, I was in a hot tub with Bob Dylan. And you're like, what do you mean? And then you later find out that it's true. He was in a hot tub with Bob Dylan.
Yeah, or like Bono in the Ford Focus. Have you heard that one?
No.
Bono was here and he walked him to his car and he was driving a Ford Focus. they're so good. And then yes, I had coffee with him yesterday. Uh-huh. Like we sit in a four top on different sides, you know. Uh-huh.
You sit in different restaurants and talk on the phone. Yeah.
And I'm sure this is true because it's easily Googleable. And I was trying to Google it, and then I asked Siri, I had my glasses on, you cut all this part out. But he said that Mussolini in the end, I know he got executed, but he said they chopped his head off and kicked his head around through all the different towns like a soccer ball. And I just assumed it was true. And then this morning I thought, I wonder if that is true.
I don't think that is true.
Really?
Yeah, I actually don't think that is true. And I happen to know a lot about, why does he make
dream.
That shit up? What they really did to Mussolini is good enough. They hung him upside down in a gas station in Milan and pelted him with stones and then kicked him for days and then stuffed him in a coffin that was too small and buried
him. Kicked him for
days. That's good enough. Yeah, but they didn't cut off his head and kick it around throughout the different towns, and it's not used regularly in soccer tournaments. No.
I heard it went all the way down Italy until they kicked it off the tip of the boot.
The boot went, and Mussolini went, enough is enough.